哈利路亚，奉主耶稣圣名正道。
Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus, I speak.
靠着圣灵的帮助。
Relying on the power of the Holy Spirit.
我们继续来分享，来学习但以理书第一章里面的信息。
We shall continue to study into the message in Daniel chapter 1.
在第一章里面，我们传道分成三个主题，小主题来分享。
I have divided Daniel chapter 1 into three sub-teams.
第一个主题叫做神国被困。
The first one is the kingdom of God was besieged.
这是一节到二节的信息。
This is the message in verses 1 and 2.
第二个题目叫做撒旦的诡计。
The second theme is the Satan's schemes.
那是三节到七节。
It is from verses 3 to 7.
那今天我们要来分享第三个小主题。
Today we shall talk about the third section.
叫做分别为圣。
To consecrate ourselves.
那分别为圣呢，是信仰上一个很重要的真理。
Consecrating ourselves is a very important point in our life of faith.
也是神对每一位神儿女至重要的要求。
It is also a request that God wants from us.
所以神这么样说。
That is why God said.
神说你们要圣洁。因为我是圣洁的。
God said, "You must be holy, for I, the Lord your God, am holy."
圣经又这样的提醒我们。
The Bible also reminds us.
人非圣洁，就不能够见神的面。
Without holiness, we cannot see God.
要见神的面，一定要圣洁。
If you want to see God, you must be holy.
若我们不圣洁，是没有一个人可以见到神的。
Without such, we will not be able to see God.
那当神的国被困。
When the kingdom of God was besieged,
当神的选民被掳
when the people of God was taken exile,
当神殿器皿被放在偶像庙的时候
when the vessels in the articles in the house of God was taken exile,
大家看到的都是失败，信仰的失败，以色列国的失败，以色列选民的失败。
All that we see is the failure of the people of God, the Israelites.
甚至大家看到的就是一种羞耻，以色列的羞耻，甚至也是神的一个羞耻。
We also see it as the shame of the Israelite nation, as well as God's shame.
因为外邦人，包括巴比伦人。巴比伦国的人，世界的人都会讥笑我们的神，你们的神在哪里？
Because the people of the world, the Babylonian people, Babylonians, they will mock at our, they will mock at us and ask us, where is your God?
从表面上看，确实是这样，确实是。
Superficially, it may be so.
但是在里面深藏着神至高的旨意。
But if you were to delve deeper, you can see the will of God.
神没有失败。
God did not fail.
失败的是以色列人。
The ones who fail are the Israelites.
但是也不是完全全部以色列人失败的。
But it is not the entire Israelite nation who failed.
当这件事情发生的时候呢，在里面深藏着神至高的旨意。
When all this was happening, it shows us the great will of God.
是什么旨意呢？
And what is the sovereign will of God?
大家有看到吗？
Do you see this?
神借着这件被掳的事情，进行信仰大扫除。
Through this incident where the people was taken exile, God did a thorough cleansing.
把那些不好的、污秽的、虚假的信仰、不圣洁的、那些拜偶像的，全部扫除干净。借助这件事情被掳，全部清扫干净。
Through this incident of the people of God taken exile, God discard all those that is not healthy, discard all those that is not holy.
那留下的就是圣洁的、忠诚的、爱神的、有真实信仰的、有真敬畏神的，留下来的就是这些圣洁的。
What is left behind are those who are holy and those who are fit to serve the Lord.
这是但以理书很重要的信息，重要的真理。
This is a very important message in the book of Daniel and a very important.
这也是但以理书中一个很重要的见证。
This is also a very important testimony in the book of Daniel.
就是分别为圣。
That is to consecrate ourselves.
神把不好的、把污秽的、把虚假的信仰去清。来一次大扫除，把它清干净它。
God will do a thorough cleansing to all those faith that is not found genuine.
这就是我们今天要分享的题目，分别为圣。
This is our theme tonight, consecrate ourselves.
我们发现到在主耶稣讲的道理当中。
We notice that in the sermons of our Lord.
将来主耶稣第二次再来的时候。
When Jesus comes again.
我们神的国还要进行第二次的拣选。
The kingdom of God will go through a second selection.
什么叫 我们在我们信仰里面要经历两次的大拣选。
In our life of faith, we will have to go through these two process, two kinds of selection.
第一次就是神在世界中，在万民中拣选我们进入真教会，进入神的国，那是第一次。
The first round is where God will select us out of the people of the world.
那第二次他要再临的时候，要进天国的时候，他再一次的进行选举拣选。
The second time is as we are about to enter the kingdom of God, God will once again select us.
主耶稣说，他要派天使坐下来挑选，把好的收起来，把不好的丢到火里面去，那是进行第二次的挑选啊！挑选比拣选更严厉的，更细腻的。
God said, before he comes again, he will send his angels to select us.
那比第一个拣选，比第一个拣选更细腻、更严格的，因为挑选不是拣选，是挑选。
It will be stricter than the first selection.
这个就是很重要的一个真理了，就是要我们分好的就是圣洁的、忠诚的、真实的就留下来了。不好的就丢了。
So this is for us to learn those that is good, God will take the holy ones. God will take and He will discard the unholy ones.
我们看但以理书要看到这个很重要的真理、重要的道理
So as we read the book of Daniel, we must be able to see this truth.
那我们细下去看，就看到但以理及他的三个朋友们都是圣洁的，都是真信仰的，都是爱神的、敬畏神的。都是荣耀神的。
As we read on the story of Daniel and his three friends, we can see that they were loyal and they loved God dearly.
好，那现在我们来看分别为圣这一段信息。
Let us see this message, consecrating ourselves.
请大家请读八节到十六节。
We read Daniel chapter 1, verses 8 to 16.
请念。
Verse 8, but Daniel purposed in his heart that he would not defile himself with a portion of the king's delicacies, nor with the wine which he drank. Therefore, he requested of the chief of the eunuchs that he might not defile himself. Verse 9, now God had brought Daniel into the favor and goodwill of the chief of the eunuchs. Verse 10, and the chief of the eunuchs said to Daniel, I fear my lord the king, who has appointed your food and drink, for why should he see your faces looking worse than the young men who are your age? Then he would endanger my head before the king. Verse 11, so Daniel said to the steward whom the chief of the eunuchs had set over Daniel, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah. Verse 12, please test your servants for 10 days, and let them give us vegetables to eat and water to drink. 13, then let our appearance be examined before you, and the appearance of the young men who eat the portion of the king's delicacies, and as you see fit, so deal with your servants. Verse 14, so he consented with them in this matter, and tested them 10 days. Verse 15, and at the end of 10 days, their features appeared better and fatter in flesh than all the young men who ate the portion of the king's delicacies.
16节是吗
Verse 16, thus the steward took away their portion of delicacies and the wine that they were to drink and gave them vegetables.
好，从这里我们有没有看到分别为圣这个重要的真理
From here, can we see this important truth about consecrating ourselves?
我们看到丹尼里以及他的朋友们那几位信徒古圣徒都是过得胜的生活。得胜的生活。
We can see that Daniel and his three friends, these ancient saints, they have led a life of victory.
第八节一开始就说，但以理不吃王的膳和王所饮的酒，他都不吃这些。
Here in verse 8, Daniel has already purposed in his heart that he would not defile himself with a portion of the king's delicacies.
为什么呢
？Why is that?
这里很清楚说，免得玷污自己，让自己污秽。
Here is very clear. It tells us that lest he defile himself.
这很清楚，那个就是分别为圣啊。
And this is consecrating himself.
把自己从污秽中分别出来啊。把自己在偶像的 国度里面分别出来、
He consecrated himself from this world of filthiness.
当那个假先知巴兰因为贪财要咒诅神显明的时候
，When Balaam, because of his greed, he wanted to curse the people of Israel.
神改变他咒诅的话。
God changed the words of his cursing.
那这个贪财的假先知，他怎样称呼这些神的选民，还记得吗
？And do you still remember how this greedy Balaam addressed the people of Israel?
他说，他从山上看下去，看到这些神的选民是独居的民，独居的，不列在万民中的。
He said that he looked down into the people of Israel, and that they are not among all other nations.
这句话就表示见证的神的百姓，神的儿女们是不列在万民中，不属世界的，完全属神的，是独居的。
And this testifies that the people of Israel, they are not belonging to the world.
那这个就是分别为圣啊。
And this is being consecrating them.
神把我们从世界中分别出来，从万民中分别出来，把我们从万民中拯救出来，属于他。
God has taken us out of this world, out of this filthy world, to belong to Him, to consecrate us.
这就是今天传道借着圣灵，靠着圣灵要跟大家学习勉励的题目，分别为圣。
And this is the topic that I would like to encourage one another with, consecrate ourselves.
那今天很多人看第八节都会有一个感觉说，为什么那么傻？
And today, many people, when they read verse 8, they will think to themselves, why is he so stupid?
为什么有的吃而不吃呢？
Why didn't Daniel eat what was given to him?
为什么有的拿而不拿呢？
Or why didn't he take what was given?
为什么有的享受而不要享受呢？
Why didn't he enjoy what was given to him?
这个又不是你去讨的，也不是你去抢的，是王给的，是免费的。
It is not something that he robbed, but it is something that was given free to him by the king.
所以为什么这么傻？
So why was he so stupid?
而且你这样不领王的膳王的酒、哦、那你会得罪王，也会得罪你的长官的。
And in a way, by rejecting what was given to him by the king, he would also offend the king as well as the eunuch.
这到底是傻还是笨呢？
Is this being foolish or is this being stupid?
真的，我们的行为、哦、有时我们的决定，对世界的人来说，我们是傻的，我们甚至是愚蠢的。
Sometimes our decisions and our actions will be deemed stupid and foolish by the people of the world.
但可能教会里面一些属世的、贪爱世界的那些信徒，可能也会认为我们这样做是很傻、很笨的。
Even some of the other believers in the church will think that what we have done is stupid.
我以前还没有当传道时候，在社会工作。
And before I was a preacher when I was still working in the society.
我是在建筑业里面工作的。
I was in a construction line.
我的老板都对其他的那些承包商说，这个是傻的，这个人是傻的，是废的，是没用的。
My employer was telling the others that this man is rather foolish.
真的好几次在同事的面前都这样直接这样说我。
And there were a few times that he rebuked me in such a way.
他们就问为什么你说说我是傻的呢？他们就问啊，问老板为什么说他是傻的呢？ Then, 为什么说他是笨的呢？
So my colleagues would ask the employer why is it that he would say that the preacher.
老板说这个人呢都不会享受的，不懂享受的。
So my employer will say that, oh, this man does not know how to enjoy.
也不懂得去享乐，去玩女人，去赌博，去赌马，跑马，喝酒，去酒吧，什么都不会的，那不是笨，不是蠢的吗？
He does not know about womanizing or gambling or doing other vice. Isn't this being foolish?
那当时的建筑界都很好这种，很喜欢这种生活，这种环境，也常常去这些地方的。
And at that time, this is very prevalent among those in the construction industry.
所以在社会，人家看到我们的行为，看到我们的生活，真的是傻是笨的。有的享受不会享受的，有的快乐不会去找快乐的。
When we consecrate ourselves in the society, others will think that we are very foolish.
但是这个是什么？
But what is this?
这就是圣经说的分别为圣，分别出来。
This is what the Bible says, consecrating ourselves.
那一直到我在教会里面进神学院。
Right until the time when I entered into the theological
seminary. 进神学院那几年，包括出来，都还有人在问，在跟我说，你为什么这么傻？
Right.
我毕业出来，还有人一直在问我这个问题，你为什么这么傻？
Right until the time after I graduated from the theological seminary, there were still questions asking me why am I so foolish.
传道去当传道，放下世界，在他们来看，在一些人的眼里看是傻的，是笨的。
For the preacher to put aside his his work, to sacrifice himself for the Lord is foolish.
讲到这里我就很感慨。
So I am
很多感触了。
I have deep feelings for this.
在社会工作，老板说我傻的、笨的；在教会当传道，教会的人说我是傻的、是笨的。
When I was in the society working, my employer said I was foolish. And when I'm working in church, there are also members who say that I'm foolish.
我讲的事情都是真真实实的事。
And these are all facts.
所以现在看第八节，不吃王的膳，不喝王的酒。那真的在一些人眼里是傻是笨的呀。
So Daniel in verse 8, he did not eat of the king's food, nor did he drink of the king's wine. So in the eyes of the people of the world, this is being very foolish.
所以兄弟姐妹， 你认为呢？是笨的，是傻的吗？
Brothers and sisters, what do you think? Is he being foolish?
好，那为什么不吃王的膳，喝王的酒呢？有三种原因呢、
Why did he not eat of the king's food and drink of the king's wine? There are three reasons.
第一，因为律法上不洁净的物是不可以吃的，律法上很多不干净的动物不可以吃的。
Under the law, there are many unclean food and drink that they are not supposed to touch.
但是在巴比伦王哪有这种法律啊？那种律法呀，没有这种律法呀。
But in the kingdom of Babylon, there was no such law.
第二
，Secondly,
王的生活，他的饮食常常都跟偶像有关系的。
The king's food and drink very often it is related to the idols.
有时要表示哈、王对这些他们的假神偶像忠心哈、真诚哈、他们先拿这些事物去孝敬他们的神，然后才来用餐的。
Very often, to show their loyalty to their gods, they will first offer them to their gods to the gods before they eat it.
那不吃王的膳，不喝王的酒的重点哦，其实圣经自己有答案啊，我们不用去猜想，自己有答案。
Not to eat of the king's food and drink of the king's wine, the answer is in the Bible.
这里说不要玷污自己啊，那就等于说是不圣洁的咯。
Here it tells us that he would not defile himself to show that these food are unclean.
那么、我们从这里看到、但以理呢在巴比伦、保守圣洁，分别为圣。
From here we can see that when Daniel was in the land of Babylon, he was able to consecrate himself.
而且这里特别讲在饮食中分别为圣，在饮食吃的方面分别出来。
Here is specially mentioned to us that in food he was able to consecrate.
分别为圣的道理有很多种，有很多层面。
And there are many areas of this consecrating ourselves.
比如说是我们的思想啦，思想的圣洁啦。
For example, in our thoughts.
还有心的圣洁啦。
In our heart.
还有行为上的圣洁啦。
In our conduct.
但是就很少讲到吃的圣洁。
But we seldom mention about not defiling ourselves in terms of.
这里所讲的分别为圣。特别是指出在吃方面分别为圣，在吃方面分别出来。
Here, this consecrating ourselves here is in terms of food and drink.
吃的问题、在以色列人在旷野发生了一个很大的悲剧，还记得吗？吃的问题。
Do you still remember the incident of the Israelites, in terms of food?
因为他们想吃肉啊，结果吃出祸来，吃出死亡来。
Because they wanted to eat meat, as a result, they died.
圣经说神用最重的灾殃啊击杀他们。
The Bible mentioned that God used this plague to kill them.
并且称那个地方为基波罗哈他瓦，就是贪欲之人的坟墓，贪心的人、贪吃的人都葬在这里，都死在这里。
The name of the place was called Kibroth Hattaava.
那个重点是因为吃啊。
And the point there is because of food.
他们不是去拜偶像，知道吗？
They were not worshipping idols.
吃出祸来呀、
It is because of food that they brought disaster.
这是我们很少去注意到的一个严重问题来。
And this is one thing that we seldom take note of.
那第二个例子也是吃出祸来的是谁呢？
And the second example who is the second example?
那当然就是我们的始祖亚当跟夏娃了，那不用讲了。
Of course, it is our ancestor Adam and Eve.
他是不是吃出祸来？
He ate the wrong food and it brought disaster upon himself.
神说不可以吃，他就跑去吃。魔鬼说可以吃啊，你试试看啊，吃了也不一定死，就一吃下去就死了。那是不是吃出祸来呢？
God said, "You shall not eat of it," but the devil said, "You can eat of it." So in the end, Adam ate of it and he brought disaster upon himself.
我们忽略了这个吃的圣的分别为圣哦。
We have often neglected about this consecrating ourselves.
其实圣经也有提醒我们啊，关于吃要小心哦。
The Bible also tells us and reminds us to be careful of what.
所以洗礼的圣徒啊，信徒，我们常常会提醒他的，那个不可以吃拜偶像的东西，那也是吃啊。
That's why after our believers are being baptized, they will be reminded not to eat a certain food.
还有不可以吃那些热死的牲畜啊，不可以吃血啊，是不是
？They cannot eat things offered to idols and food that is strangled.
那更重要的呢，现在的吃呢，是成了一种一种神啊，赌妇的神啊。
Now the food has become this god of our belly.
以前我们都不会这样想，就是吃而已嘛，最多他喜欢吃，他就多吃嘛，他贪吃嘛。但圣经说，现在吃那个吃啊，事物成了人的神啊。
And in the past, we often think that when they like to eat too much, it is just either being greedy or just craving for food. But now, the Bible also tells us that it is, we are satisfying this God of our belly.
圣经有没有这样讲？
Did the Bible say this?
请看腓立比书第三章。
Turn to Philippians chapter 3.
腓立比书三章。
Philippians chapter
3. 十九节。
Verse 19.
这里说他们的节制就是沉沦。他们的神是什么？他们的神就是自己的赌父啊，自己一直那个吃的欲啊，吃的欲望，一直吃一直吃，哪里好吃，哪里怎么样怎么样，一直吃，成了他们的神。
So verse 19 tells us that the end is destruction and their God is their belly, so they will go after all this good food.
并不是我们不能吃。
It is not that we cannot eat.
神都是很，神都是哦，创造了很多东西让我们去享用，让我们去吃的。
God has created many kinds of food for us to eat and to enjoy.
但是这里圣经就提出是成了另一种神啊。
But here the Bible points out that this food has become another God.
哦，所以我们中国人也说民以食为天啊，最重要是吃啊。而且吃饭大过天啊，比天比神还更大啊，吃饭的时候啊。
And there is a Chinese saying that goes, food during meal time is more important than the heavens.
有我们传道提出几个例子跟圣经的勉励，让我们在吃方面你要谨慎，要分别为圣。
These are the points that I pointed out so that you can be reminded and to consecrate yourself in terms of food.
那么有三个见证关于吃的。
There are three testimonies regarding food.
有一个外教会的信徒归入真教会，归真啊。
There is this believer from another church. He was converted into our church.
他以前的教会都是吃拜偶像东西都没问题的，牧师也说可以吃的，都无所谓的。
In his former church, he was able to eat food that is offered to idols. Even his pastor allowed that.
因为他们说偶像不算的什么，保罗说偶像根本不算什么东西呀、啊。我们的神是最大呀。
They said, idols are nothing. Just like what Paul said, idols are nothing, and our God is greater.
他洗礼过后有一次，他不小心吃到祭偶像之物，不是故意的啦。
After baptism, he accidentally ate something that was offered to idols.
还是他已经忘记了，因为在他外教会都可以的呀。
Or perhaps he may have forgotten because in the other church he was able to.
结果那天晚上他肚子痛到要死啊，一直吐，一直呕啊，一直吐啊。
As a result, that evening he continued. He just vomited.
痛到他整个人没有办法走路，没有办法站起来那种，而且一直流出冷汗。脸整个青青没有力量。
He was in such great pain that he was not able to move, and he was sweating profusely.
他就在反省，祷告中反省，就想起是不是刚才吃了祭偶像的东西。
He prayed and he reflected once upon himself, and he was wondering whether it was the food that he ate a while ago that was offered to idols.
他打电话去问，去了解，真的是拜过偶像的。
And he called up to inquire, and true enough, the food that he just ate was actually offered to idols.
他就在想，为什么我在外教会的时候都没有事啊？我在教会也是信耶稣啊，吃了多少拜偶像都没事，一到真耶稣教会吃就有事呢？
He was thinking to himself, why is it that when he was in his former church, he was still able to eat food offered to idols, but in the true Jesus church, he was not able to.
这个见证告诉我们，真教会跟外教会不同点。分别为圣，已经真教是分别出来了，你又倒回去那些无谓的东西，无谓的大家无谓当然没事，但是你已经圣洁了，你再吃无谓的东西，那肯定有事呀。这个叫做分别为圣，已经圣洁了。
This testimony tells us that once you have been consecrated, once you are baptized into this church, you have been consecrated, and therefore you have to you cannot defile yourself anymore.
这是吃的一个见证。
And this is a testimony on food.
第二个也是吃的见证。
A second one is also on food.
有一个信徒常常赶鬼，鬼出去，鬼又来，鬼出去，鬼来，为什么会这样呀？
There was this believer. When we cast out the demon, the demon will go out and then it will come back.
后来去了解。奉主的名叫他说出来，要奉主的名他才肯讲出来。
Later, we asked him in the name of Jesus to tell us what happened.
原来他常常去偶像的庙里面，甚至在那边吃祭偶像的东西。
Actually, he often go to the temple and he would eat food there.
那有一次更离谱，就是七夜节，七夜节就是鬼节嘛，鬼门开嘛，阴间的鬼全部放出来到人间嘛。那么我们那些拜偶像的人就在那边就做大戏给那些鬼看啊，然后就在那边 煮一个煮大大锅饭给鬼吃呀。
So there was once on the seventh month, the month of the hungry ghost, he was helping out in the temple to cook.
Yeah, 他也帮忙去煮，当然也一起吃了。
So when he helped them to cook, he actually also ate together with
them. 吃到许多鬼附在他身上。
So he ate so much that there were a lot of many demons actually possessed him.
这个也是个吃的见证。
This is a testimony about food.
那我想。还有一个见证也是关于吃的。
And there is also another testimony about food.
我们信徒他的邻居 是拜拜的，然后他们 在拜鬼节的时候呢，就买了一些糕点拜祭鬼的来给他，送给他。
One of our church believers, the neighbor was celebrating this feast of the hungry ghost, and they bought some cakes and gave it to him.
那么他就说这些祭鬼的我们不能吃的。
He told the neighbor, this food offered to idols we cannot eat.
哦，这个邻居说，哦，这个没有祭鬼的，祭鬼的是另外的，那个是在街边呐，在庙旁边、庙堂旁边摆摊卖的糕点来的，没有拿去拜的。
So
那这个没问题。
So the neighbor told him, this food is okay because it is not being offered to idols. It is just by the side of the temple.
那他又不好意思拒绝。
So he felt very embarrassed to reject.
他就把这些不圣洁的这糕点放在厨房的桌子上，厨房的桌子上。
So he just placed the food that was given to by the neighbor in the kitchen.
他想明天呢、送给别人去吃还是怎么样了？明天才处理了。
So he thought to himself, maybe I will give this to somebody else the following day.
晚上鬼来他的家呀，好多次鬼来他的家呀。
And that night, many devils came to his house.
他在睡觉的时候，他的女儿拍他的房门啊，不敢自己睡觉啊。
At night, the daughter kept knocking at his door. She was afraid to sleep alone.
他自己从楼上走经过厨房的时候，经过那个糕点的时候，他自己都感觉到害怕，不对劲啊。
And when she came downstairs and walked to the kitchen, as he passed through the cake, he himself was afraid.
那他就知道这些糕点不圣洁。
Then he knew that the cakes were defiled.
他就祷告。
So he prayed.
祷告的时候，圣灵责备他。
And when during his prayer, the Holy Spirit rebuked him.
为什么将这些不洁净的物带回家里，放在家里
？Why did you take back this food that has been defiled?
虽然那个糕没有真正拿去祭偶像
，although the food has not been offered to the idols，
但是那个摆摊子的那个卖糕的，为什么摆在那个偶像庙旁边？就是拿来卖给他们去拜的呀，是准备祭偶像的呀。所以给偶像的东西来的。
But the fact that the food was sold by at the store at the entrance of the temple is for the people to go into the temple and to bring this food to offer to their gods.
这个糕不是巴萨我们市场买的那些一般上的糕，不是那个发糕啊，红色的，那个是专拜拜用的。
These cakes
拜神的人拜偶像很喜欢用那种糕来祭偶像的。
These cakes are not purchased from the market, but it is specially made to offer to the idols.
我顺便这样讲啊，因为这些见证应该对我们的信仰，对我们生活上也有一些警醒，应该有一些帮助。
I mention this because it might serve as a good help and a reminder to us.
分别为圣的道理很多层面，但是这里我们看到次方面你要留意。
To consecrate ourselves, we can see in many areas, but in this, we can see in terms of food.
那接下去第八节。
We read, continue to read verse 8.
分别为圣，不是口嘴巴讲啊，我们要分别为圣，也不是心里想啊，我要分别为圣，不是的，不是这样子的。
Consecrating ourselves is not just merely service.
分别为圣是要下定决心，立志保守圣洁的。
To consecrate ourselves, you must be determined and you must make a resolution.
看到吗？第八节。
Do you see in verse 8?
但以你立志不以神王的膳和王饮的酒玷污是立志啊！原来在次方面的这个小事情的这种分别为圣当中，也要立志啊，要用心智来去完成它的呀。
So verse 8, Daniel purposed in his heart. In other words, even small matters like food, he had to make a strong determination not to eat.
好，那么我们继续看下去。
You continue reading.
活出荣耀圣洁的见证。
To live a life of testimony.
那他们就要求这个掌管这个隐士的太监哈，给他们素菜，还有白开水就好。
So the three Daniel and his three friends requested of the chief of the eunuch that they will be given vegetables and water.
然后那个管理膳食的哦，不肯啊。
But the chief of the eunuch refused.
他说：“如果这样，你们不营养不够，你们的脸色苍白难看，我怎么样向王交代呀、
啊、？”If you were malnourished and if you look pale, what am I going to tell the king?
你有信心
，You may have faith，
但是人家外邦人没有这种信心，也没有这样的认识啊。
But if the Gentiles do not have this faith and do not have this recognition，
变成我们的要求也为难到对方，让对方很为难。
Then it may look as though our request will put them in a difficult position。
但是我们又要分别为圣，那怎么办呢
？But we want to consecrate ourselves。
那但以理就提出一个方案。
So Daniel gave one a suggestion.
这样吧，你试试我们十天吧，用十天来试试看吧。
Why don't you test us for 10 days?
十天只吃素菜跟白开水就好。
For these 10 days, we will only eat vegetables and drink water.
如果我们的面貌是营养不够了，是惹起王的愤怒了，那你就看怎么做吧。
If we look malnourished and if we have incurred the wrath of the king, then you may do as you wish.
请注意啊，求你试试我们十天这句话，并不是没有信心，并不是表示但以理没有信心，不是。
The words of Daniel, please test your servant for 10 days, does not mean that he has no faith.
用十天试试看，是因为对方没有信心。
To test them for 10 days, it is because the opposite party has no faith.
所以你要搞清楚哦，但以理提出这个方案，讲出这句话，不是他没有信心哦，是对方没有信心啊。
So when Daniel gave this suggestion to test them for 10 days, it is not because they do not have faith.
你有信心不代表别人也有信心的，知道吗？
Sometimes we may have faith, but it doesn't mean others have faith.
有时我们也要多为别人想一想啊。
Sometimes we need to be considerate for others.
过了十天，就照你所看的待我们吧。
After 10 days, you may decide for yourself.
这是什么话呢？
What does this mean?
这句话就是完全的交托，我把这件事情交托给神。如果神答应，神许愿，一定会带领。如果这句神不许愿，神不成全，那么就照你的方法咯，我完全交托给神啊，没问题。
In other words, I will entrust this whole matter to God's hand. If everything works well, then it is God's will.
这句话也表示出完全的顺服，看神的旨意如何，神要怎样都 OK。
This is also to show that they have faith and whatever God's will is, they will accept.
完全的交托，完全的顺服，等于什么呢？等于无论结果是怎样，我都会接受。
When they completely entrust it to God, it shows that whatever the outcome is, they will accept.
有时我们这样有信心这样做，但是结果出来却是没有果效的呢，有时会这样呢。
At times we may have faith, but the end of it does not manifest what we want.
那但以理的意思说，没关系啊，那无论结果是怎样，我都接受，我都顺服呀，没关系啊。
But in the case of Daniel, he was willing to accept whatever the outcome is.
因为这里面看神的意思怎么样咯。
He was waiting for what God will do.
所以我们看到许多信徒遇到患难的时候，他不去祷告，他甚至禁食祷告。
We can see that some of the members, when they are in difficulty, they will pray and they will fast.
特别要医好他的孩子啊，他的家人啊，他的父亲啊，还是什么
？Perhaps they are praying for healing, for their father or for their children.
他也真的禁食哦。
And they may truly fast and pray.
结果呢，不是他所得到的，却不是他所要的。神没有成全他的祷告，神也没有因为他的禁食来成全他，没有。
But God may not answer him according to his request.
结果这些信徒大部分就是开始埋怨，甚至不能够接受，甚至对神发脾气。
It is at that time that some of these people they will murmur against God and even vent their tantrum against God.
这种当初的信心，当初的禁食是表示什么呢
？And what is this initial fasting and prayer? What does that
表示说神，我这样做，你一定要照我的意思，你一定要听我，你一定要医治我的父亲，你一定要医我的病，因为我这样做，因为我禁食。因为我祷告了。
Does it mean that just because they have fasted and prayed that God must answer their prayer according to their request?
那个是你的意思啊。
That may be your own wish.
神的意思是另外是另一种呀。
But God's will is entirely different.
但是你不能接受了。
But you may not be able.
你不能够顺服神给你的安排了。
You may not be able to submit to God's will.
因为神有更好的，比你想象中更好的安排。
Because God has a better arrangement for you.
所以我们有时进食祷告，我们祷告迫切进食。是要用这种哦来命令神听哦强迫神听我们而已，有时变成这样的。
Sometimes, in our fasting and prayer, we tend to force God to answer according to our prayers.
那、啊、你看但以理的祷告是不是这样呢
？But is Daniel praying in this line?
好、哦，他要立志分辨为圣，那是合乎神旨意的。
He wanted to consecrate himself. He wanted to resolve to consecrate himself.
绝对是合乎神的旨意的。
This is definitely in accordance to God.
可是他怎么讲呢
？But what did he say?
十天后看看怎么样喽。如果没有成效，没有果效，那就随你了。他接受这种的结果，万一结果是这样，神没有答应，神没有行神迹，他说我也顺服呀，我不会埋怨神啊。
She said, "You may test me for 10 days, and whatever the outcome at the end of the 10 days, I will accept."
但耶利因为这种正确的信心哦，对神正确的祷告态度哦，结果他真的在荣耀神，神得到很大的荣耀。
And because of his correct faith and genuine faith, God was glorified.
神也很喜悦他这样的行为，他这样的信心，他这样的祷告，他这样的态度。
God also found favor in his attitude and in his prayer.
所以神的作为就彰显在但以理他们的身上。
Hence, the greatness of God was manifested in Daniel and his three
friends. 比用王膳的少年人更加俊美肥胖啊，吃喝白开水，吃青菜，还更加健康美丽啊。
In the end, after the 10 days, his appearance was better than the others.
这就是神的作为啦，神的同在，神的喜悦，神的荣耀。
And this is God's sovereign power, God abiding in them, and God's glory.
而且这种神同在、神喜悦的见证呢，是实实在在的，连别人都可以感受到，别人都清清楚楚看到的。
And these testimonies where God abides in them is very clearly manifested to others, and they can see it clearly.
当我们立志保守圣洁、过分别为圣生活的时候
，When we resolve to lead a holy life,
我们便能够活出更加俊美、更加美丽的见证。更加美丽的这种信仰
，We will be able to live out a more beautiful life, a better faith.
因为圣洁
，It is because we are able to be.
那么就有人问一个问题
，Some people they will ask.
这些哈、哦，只是吃白开水、吃青菜，一直吃到他死为止吗？一直这样分辨为圣，不吃肉，一直到他丹尼里去世吗？
Did Daniel and his friends eat vegetables and drink water for the entire life until he died?
当然他是不吃王的膳跟酒啦，因为那个是说不要玷污自己嘛，那是肯定的啦。
Of course, he did not want to defile himself by eating the king's food and the king's wine.
但是难道也不吃肉吗
？But does that mean he did not eat meat?
因为这十天只是吃青菜跟白开水罢了，没有吃肉的，知道吗？
Because during this 10-day period, they did not eat meat, only vegetables.
那是不是他们这几个人都一直就这样吃素呢？就一直到死呢？是不是这样
？But does it mean that for the rest of their life, they continued to eat vegetables and water?
你想要知道答案吗
？Do you want to know the answer?
我们看圣经哈、哦，圣经的答案啊。
We see from the Bible.
这里应该可以给我们一个答案了。
We can derive some answers from here.
请看但以理书的第十章。
Daniel chapter 10.
但以理书第十章第二节。
Daniel chapter 10 verse 2.
当那个时候，我但以理悲伤了三个七日，三个七日就是21天哦，悲伤27天。
Daniel was mourning for three whole week.
他在进食祷告嘛。
He was praying and fasting.、哦、
第三节。
Verse 3.
美味我没有吃。酒跟肉也没有入我的口，也没有用油抹我的身体，直到满了三个七日，直到满了21天。
Daniel did not eat any pleasant food, nor meat, nor wine, and he did not anoint himself at all for three whole weeks.
他在这里很清楚说他在进食祷告三个星期21天呢。
Here it was very clear that yeah, Daniel.Fasted for 3 weeks.
什么原因让他禁食呢
？Why did he fast?
你就看第一节的，他看到那个异象，大征战的异象。
It is the vision of the great battle.
特别是关系到以色列国神的百姓神的选民他很忧心啊他祷告求神让他明白这些事情。
Especially when it pertains to the future of the Israelite nation, he prayed to God to be able to understand.
那直到满三个七日满过后他就吃了咯。
And after three weeks, he ate.
是啊他只是说三个七日没有吃肉没有喝酒没有用油抹身啊那除了这三个礼拜那应该正常生活就是有咯不然就不会这样讲不会这样写啊。
So it is only during that 3 weeks period that he did not eat meat or drink wine.
是吗？酒本来就是可以喝的啊，不是不能喝呀。本来就可以的，神也允许的呀。
You may be able, you can drink wine.
那肉也本来就是可以吃的啊，为什么不可以吃呢？本来就神就说你们要吃肉啊。
God also said, meat is allowed to eat.
所以我们的一个错误的教导哦，那些幼儿班的老师，宗教界。教导到就是吃白开水吃青菜这样一生人都这样分别为圣我看有些误差了这里应该有误差了啦。
There may be some misconception where some RE teachers will teach their children that they can just feed on vegetables and water for the rest of their
life. 没关系啦只是让大家了解一下而已啦哈。但以理他是过正常生活也有吃肉也有喝一些酒的啦。他自己讲的呀。
I believe Daniel led a very normal life. He even ate meat and drink wine. It's only this period that he abstained from.
但是这些道理，现在听一个属灵的人听了，哇，这样他就不圣洁，这样他就没有分别为圣了。那你不知道什么叫做分别为圣啊？你不是真正的明白什么叫做分别为圣、啊。
But sometimes people will misconstrue all this and say that Daniel did not consecrate himself.
哦。再来，我们继续看下去。
We continue.
17-20节。
Verses 17-20.
那在这一段里面呢，看到神赐给他们哦，各样文学上各样聪明知识啊、哦，各样智慧。
Here we can see that God gave them knowledge, skill in all literature and wisdom.
这里说他们的聪明智慧是神所赐的。
Here it tells us that God was the one who gave them this knowledge and skill.
而且哦。这几个古圣徒的智慧胜过埃及的术士十倍啊，不是一倍两倍，胜过他们十倍啊。
And here it tells them that their knowledge is actually 10 times better than all the magicians and astrologers.
请注意哦，神选民的智慧远远胜过世人的聪明智慧，知道吗？
Please take note that the wisdom and understanding of the people of God is actually surpass the people of the world.
因为神选民的智慧是直接从神来，神所赏赐。
Because the wisdom of God actually from the wisdom that we have is actually from God.
世人的聪明智慧只在今生，只在这个世界寻找、努力学习而得到的。怎样得到、怎样学习都是世界的，在世界寻找的智慧聪明。
The knowledge and understanding of the people of the world are what they acquire in this world.
简单说是从世界来的。
In other words, it is from.
再聪明也是从世界学到的。
And no matter how intelligent they may be, it is still from the world.
但是神儿女的智慧直接从上头来的，神那边赐下来给我们的。
But the wisdom of the children of God is from above, from God Himself.
而且我们神儿女的智慧啊，的重点就是因为我们的智慧是看到永恒，进入永恒里面去。
And it is this wisdom that enables us to see into eternity.
世人的聪明智慧怎样都放在这个世界，怎样都看重这个世界，怎样都花在这个世界上，它不会说是为永恒的，不会。
The intelligence of the people of this world is only for this world, and it is not into eternity.
再看这个，所以聪明智慧哦，请注意哦，我们做父母的，我们都希望我们的儿女有聪明智慧。
So as parents, we must be mindful of this. We all wish that our children have this knowledge and wisdom.
其实方法很简单。
The method is very easy.
就是我们做父母要学会敬畏神。
As parents, we must learn to fear God.
然后也教导儿女们敬畏神。
Therefore, we must also teach our children to fear God.
整个家庭就有智慧，你也有智慧，儿女一定也有智慧。
Then the whole family would have wisdom, the parents would have wisdom, and the children.
这个是圣经教导我们的方法呀。
This is what the Bible teaches.
怎样得到智慧啊
？How to acquire wisdom?
你就敬畏神啊。
Fear God.
哦，敬畏神是智慧的开端嘛，是开哦，智慧的那种开始嘛。
Fear God is the beginning of wisdom.
我信神，我信神讲的这句话。
I believe in the words of God.
那除了要学习的，那当然要学习一些知识嘛，生活上的啊，课本上的啊，这个历史啊，各种的学问啊，医学，那我们要去学。但是呢，真正的聪明智慧呢，神给，敬畏神就有，敬畏神，神就是。
When it comes to knowledge and understanding and intelligence of the world, we need to pursue them in our schools.
我们都说所罗门王很有智慧，有没有？
But when it comes to wisdom, we need it from God. We often say that Solomon is very wise.
那你知道他的智慧从哪里来吗？
Do you know where he got his wisdom?
我们都知道他的智慧是神赐给他的，有没有？神给他的，是吧？
We know that God gave Solomon wisdom.
但是请你注意，所罗门神还没有赐他智慧之前。神还没有赐所罗门智慧之前，你看所罗门王他选择什么？你看所罗门他选择什么？他在做什么？
Take note. Before God even gave Solomon wisdom, what did Solomon wish to have?
他选择什么就决定了他的智慧。
The thing that he chose would determine his wisdom.
因为晚上的时候神来找他嘛，他睡觉的时候做梦，神来找他。
God appeared to him at night.
神就问他，你要我赐你什么呢？
God asked him, "What do you want me to give you?"
那你就可以求啊。
You can ask.
那他求什么呢？
What did he ask?
他说，你给我的这么多子民，我没办法来带领他们啊，我没有智慧来管理他们。求你使我有智慧来管理你的百姓，这些都是你的孩子，你的子民啊，我要怎么样带领他？你给我这种智慧来管理他们。
He said, "I'm in no position to rule over all these people that you have given me. So please give me wisdom so that I may be able to govern them."
所以神还没有赐他智慧的时候，你看他选择什么？你看他在求什么
？So before God gave him wisdom, what is the thing that he asked for?
所以神说：“我许愿你啊，因为你没有为自己求长命长寿，也没有为自己求财富，你是为了神的百姓、神的国来求智慧，是为了神。”为了百姓来求，神说你没有求的，我也会给你。
So God said, "It is because you have asked for this, and you did not ask for other things, such as longevity. Therefore, I will give this wisdom to you, and those that you did not ask from me, I will also give."
那个就是所罗门得智慧的经过啊，他的聪明啊。
And this is his intelligence for asking for wisdom.
选择先求神国神义，选择先关心神的国神的百姓。没有求的神说我也会给你，这个就是他的聪明。现在神给他的不是聪明，而是智慧啊。
So he asked for God's kingdom and his righteousness and his wisdom. So God did not only give him intelligence of the world, but God gave him far more better, that is the wisdom of God.
那我们暂时就先讲到这里。
And we will stop here.
那到二十一节的时候。
In verse 21,
到古列王元年，但以理还在是什么意思呢
？What does it mean when Daniel continued until the first year of King Cyrus？
那我们就留下次讲生命的价值。
And after this, we'll talk about the value of life.
那么这个但以理他很长命呢、啊，到古列王巴比伦国都灭亡了，整个巴比伦都不存在了，他还在啊。
And to say that he continued until the first year of King Cyrus, that means even though Babylon had fallen during the year, during the reign of King, during the king, during the reign of the King Cyrus of Persia, he was still around.
你自己还讲不出。那个是什么意思呢？要告诉我们什么呢？
What does this mean? What is it trying to tell us?
很多个王都死掉了，他复试过的王都不存在的，他还存在。
He outlived many kings, and all the other kings have died, and he was still living.
哦，那就是生命要告诉我们的一个重点，一个道理是生命的价值，存在的价值。
And this is to tell us the value of life, the fact that he was still alive.
也包括信仰的价值在里面。
And this is also the value of our faith.